क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेन ड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू StudyIQ। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द महा रेरा और द महाराष्ट्र वर्जन ऑफ रेरा। रेरा इज द रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट एक्ट ऑफ 2016। And if you don't have an idea about RERA, please watch the video on StudyIQ channel on RERA, Real Estate Regulation and Development Act, so that you will have a clear picture about RERA and you will understand this lecture in a much better manner. The video on RERA is available on the StudyIQ channel and also on my Facebook page. Now let us start with Maha RERA. First of all, what is RERA? We have seen that it is the Real Estate Regulation and Development Act of 2016, and it was an act passed by the Parliament, and the aim of the act was to protect the interest of the home buyers, that is the customers, as well as to create an enabling environment that will promote investments in the country in real estate. So in order to promote the investments in real estate and also to protect the interests of the home buyers, Real Estate Regulation and Development Act of 2016 was formed, and it was formed through an act of the Parliament. It is an act, and the purpose of the act was to implement a regulator for the real estate transactions in India. And by implementation of a regulator, the buyer's confidence can be improved. As we have seen, one main purpose was to protect the interest of the home buyers in the country. Now, let us look at the status of RERA. The center enacted the model law, and the regulation is still a work in progress in most of the states. So, many of the states have not implemented the provisions of the RERA completely. And it is in this situation, Maharashtra government has set up an example for all other states in the implementation of RERA. And that is why the Maha RERA or the Maharashtra version of RERA has become important, and it has proved to be a model for all other states. So in this lecture, we will be analyzing about the Maharashtra version of RERA or the Maha RERA. Now let us see what is Maha RERA. Under the Real Estate Regulation and Development Act of 2016, that is the Central Government Act, there was a provision, and according to the provision, all the states has to establish a regulatory authority, and this regulatory authority should be capable of dealing with the issues arising from transactions in real estate sector. So, one important provision of the 2016 Central Act was that every state has to maintain a real estate regulatory authority which can deal with issues arising out of the transactions in the real estate market. And the Maharashtra government has established the Maha RERA according to this provision of the central government in March 2017, and by May 2017, all the sections of this act came into effect in Maharashtra. So we can say by May 2017, the Maharashtra government had implemented the RERA in its complete version. And under the Maharashtra version of RERA, the entire state is covered. And this means that it is mandatory for all the ongoing commercial as well as residential projects in the state to be registered with the real estate regulator. So what does the provision of RERA provide for? The provision provides that all the ongoing commercial and residential projects should be registered with the regulator. And because from May 2017, Maha RERA came into effect and it was applicable to the entire state. Under the Maha RERA, all the projects going on in the state of Maharashtra had to be registered with the real estate regulator. And secondly, the developers or the promoters in the state were not allowed to sell, book or advertise their projects without being registered. That means no transaction or no activity related to the project was allowed if they are not registered with the Maha RERA. So if they had to book or sell or even advertise their projects, they had to get registered with the RERA, the promoters or the developers. Thirdly, the Maharashtra government appointed a regulatory authority. So, a regulatory authority under Maharara was created, and this authority would deal with disclosures by the developers, registration of the projects, registration of the agents, and this authority was also responsible for taking up consumer complaints. Any aggrieved individual can file a complaint with the Maharara or with the adjudicating officer in respect to any registered or non-registered real estate project for the violation of any regulation. So, these were the provisions under the regulatory authority which was created under the Maharara. Now, let us see what makes Maharara different from all other real estate developers in other states of the country. We have seen that there was a purpose for the establishment of real estate regulator. So, what is the purpose of establishing a real estate regulator? One is to ensure accountability towards the buyers. Second one, to protect the interest of the consumers. Third one, to ensure transparency in transactions. Fourthly, to reduce delays in the project handover. Fifthly, to provide a fast-track dispute settlement mechanism. Next, another important intention is to boost the investors' confidence. And if we look at all this intentions of the real estate regulatory authority, we will see that all this were fulfilled by the Maharara. So, the Maharashtra version of RERA was able to provide accountability for the buyers, was able to protect the consumer's interest, ensure transparency in the transactions, reduce the delay in handover, dispute settlement became easy, and the investors' confidence was also strengthened. So, in all these aspects, Maharara fulfilled all the intentions of the real estate regulator. Secondly, an individual can view the projects online under the provisions of Maharara. So, this enables the buyer or the consumer to know the status of development and also the expected date of completion of the project. For example, if an individual from the state of Maharashtra wants to check a project, and the search result will give that person project type, project status, whether it is completed or ongoing, the proposed date of completion, whether it is subject to any kind of litigation, the project type, that is whether it is commercial or residential project, the address of the project, the FSI details, the number of flats booked, etc. So, all these details of the project is available to the individual online. Thirdly, Maharara has a provision for registration and the fee payment online. So, digital transactions are promoted under Maharara. And fourth important feature of Maharara is that it has provided for speedy settlement of complaints. And if we look at the statistics, out of total 4090 complaints that were registered with the Maharara, orders were passed for 2370 complaints, and this is according to the recent statistics available in the Maharara website. So we will see that more than half of the complaints were settled or orders were passed. So this amounts to speedy settlement of complaints by the regulatory authority. So, in all these ways, Maharara stands different from the RERA in other states of the country. Now, look at the significance of the Maharara. First of all, through all the provisions that are available in Maharara, the buyers or the investors can make an informed decision. They are provided with information. So, this makes them capable to make an informed decision about investment. Secondly, unless an agreement of sale is registered, no developer can accept more than 10% of the cost as advance payment from the buyer. So, if the developer or the project promoter has to get more than 10% of the funds from the investor, he has to issue the agreement of sale. So, this provision eliminates the time delay in the execution of agreement of sale and also helps the consumers in a way that they do not have to make much advance payment. Maximum advance payment is 10% until the agreement of sale is executed by the developer. Thirdly, the promoters are mandated to pay interest for every month of delay. If the project is delayed, the developer or the promoter of the project has to pay interest to the consumers. Fourthly, MahaRERA has provisions that expects the buyers also to make the payment on time. So, in that way, both the interest of buyers as well as the developers are protected under MahaRERA. So, buyers also have to make the payment on time and the promoters also will have to hand over the project on time. And fifthly, MahaRERA uploads all the registered projects across the state on an online map. So, the details of all the registered projects are available in one platform under the MahaRERA. So, this will help the prospective buyers to view the projects, and the projects which are under construction or the completed projects can be viewed by the prospective buyers and they can have a look at all the features. So, they can scrutinize the amenities. So, this provision will allow the prospective buyers to make a selection process online itself even before visiting the site. So, all the details are available online. So, this can help the consumers to save time of scrutinizing the project. All project and its details are available online to them. And all these features of the RERA Maharashtra version protects the interest of not only the buyers but also the developers, and also creates an enabling investment environment. So all this will promote the ease of doing business in the real estate industry. So this will promote investments also in this sector. And what is the policy lesson that we arrive from MahaRERA? MahaRERA proves that a regulated real estate market is first of all possible because they have proven that it is possible. And secondly, this regulated real estate market can be a win-win situation for all. So if we look at the provisions of RERA, there were lot of criticisms for many of the provisions, but the Maharashtra version has proved that this can be worth or a win-win situation for all the stakeholders, like the buyers, the promoters, developers, the authority, the government. So all the stakeholders will benefit from the provisions of the RERA. So this is also established from the Maharashtra version of RERA. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page, and also the lecture on RERA, the act which was passed by the central government, that is also available on my Facebook page and also on the StudyIQ channel. So if you don't have a clarity regarding the Central Government Act, that is Real Estate Regulation and Development Act 2016, please watch the video which I have made on RERA so that you will get better clarity regarding Maharashtra version of RERA. Thank you.
क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ, तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेनड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।